Good afternoon. Come on now, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
It might be a little sadness, but there's some joy. We'll come in the morning. Because we can may just be for a little while. Let us pray. Our Father God, we come right now thanking you for allowing us to be here. We realize, Heavenly Father, that you might have tears, but there's joy that comes in the morning. Be with this family and friends, one by one, name by name. In Jesus' name, amen. I am Pastor William Allen of Pleasant Hill Baptist Church, Winchester, Kentucky. I reside here in Bourbon County. is to read the obituary. Louis Thomas Browning, 50, of Paris, Kentucky, died Sunday, July the 25th, 2021, at the St. Joseph Hospice Care Center in Lexington, Kentucky. A native of Paris, Kentucky, he was the son of the late Larry Thomas Browning and Virginia Mae Bryan Browning. He was the owner of a taxi driving business and was affiliated with several bike clubs in Paris. He is survived by one daughter, Courtney Mae Tallarice Graves, four grandchildren, Ryan, Rosie, Michael, and Avi, fiance Jessica Chapman, five stepchildren, Carson Harris, Alicia Harris, Amit Perez, Judith Perez, and Holden Perez, one sister, Carla Mark Hawkins, and two nephews, Travis Hawkins and Parker Hawkins. In addition to his parents, he is preceded in death by his grandparents, Carl and Rose Thomas, one sister, Marianne Faye, and one brother, Jimmy Orton, and an aunt, Ruby Blake. Another song.
Don't waste your time on me. I'm so damaged beyond repair. try to get through it. The day we met, our paths didn't just cross. They merged together and became one. I always thank God for you. I knew it would be an amazing journey. You promised a love that was true. You promised a hand to hold each step along the way. You promised to take time for us. You promised to show you care. You promised to be gentle. You promised to help with all of my fears and to always dry my tears. I promised you with all my heart I would always do the same for you from the start. You was the best stepdad. My kids could have ever asked for. You treated them as your own. You was always there when someone needed you. You had a smile that would light up a room, although not many people got to see that side of you. But when they did, they loved being around you. You made every home feel right at home. You taught me what I know today and showed me things I'll forever be grateful for. You made me better in so many ways. I will forever cherish that for all of my days. I loved our time together, the bike rides, the boat trips, all of our vacations, and all the other people, places, and things along the way. You truly showed me another side of life. It's sad that your time was cut short because we had plans to be husband and wife. I dreamed about the day I would walk down the aisle to my best friend, my lover, my world, my everything. I am so grateful to have had you for the past 7 years. We had a relationship most people search a lifetime for. We were unstoppable, inseparable, and irreversible. You touched so many lives in so many ways, from your quick cab customers to the people in the little town of Paris, Kentucky. And speaking of quick cab, who could have done it any better? You were the best man for that job. You took a 2-star company and turned it into a 5-star company, which is the most successful taxi company in Lexington, Kentucky. Now here we are at the end of our journey here on earth. I'm broken and don't know if I will ever be fixable. I keep waiting for you to walk back through the door. I just want to talk with you, hold you, and fall asleep in your arms. I will never get over you. I promise to always talk about you and what an amazing person and lover you were. Just promise to watch over your family and your friends just like you did here on earth. Baby, I will never forget you and what we shared the last 7 years. But now I must say goodbye for now. So go ride the streets of gold and just know how much I love you. you know, when my work is done, I'll be coming home. Home to you. Rest in peace, baby. Lewis Thomas Browning, 12-170, 725.
I didn't know Mr. Browning personally. As a matter of fact, I met him at his daughter's wedding. And now I stand before you doing his obituary and bring a funeral. I'm not going to be long with it, but there's a scripture. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brothers and sisters, concerning them which are asleep, that your sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe in Jesus, died and rose again, even them also which sleep in Jesus will bring with him. We come today to honor the memory of Lewis T. Browning. Paul says, brothers and sisters, we do not want to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest who have no hope. We can grieve with hope, sorrow, and joy. Paul is real about grief and sorrow that death brings. Death is an enemy, and you battle an enemy. It takes away from us people we love dearly. The impact of Lewis had in our lives, those memories will live and on in our hearts. My Bible tells me that Jesus died and rose again. So I believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep with him because of Jesus' resurrection. It's the winning of the war that trumps the losing battle of death. By trusting our lives in Jesus' hands and commit to following him, we share this hope. Jesus wants us to share with everyone. It is a gift that needs to be received. The followers of Jesus' death is temporary. Parting for one day, it will end, and there will be a great, joyful reunion. Family, we must remember that God is the one who determines the length of our lives, and he knows all about us, and he is controlled, and his purpose will prevail. No matter how it looks to us, when God allows a loved one to pass, it is because he knows what is best. I encourage you to remember that God is the one who ordains our days. One of the best ways we can honor the memory of Lewis T. Browning is to honor the one who allowed him to be a part of our lives in the first place. Remember, God knows how it feels to lose a loved one. You see, God the Father sent his only son to die for you and I. Jesus' life was taken brutally at the hands of men. When you call out to God, who knows how you feel? When you call out to God, who's been there? And when you call out to God, for it is good to draw near to him. And when you call upon God in prayer, I pray that this family will stick together, become closer, because you never know. There was old cliche that said, here today and gone tomorrow. It's here today and gone today. Family, y'all get closer. Don't worry about Lewis, he's fine now. He has no more pain, no more sorrow. He's with the Father. I'm not preaching him into heaven, I'm not preaching him into hell. For he knows where he went. Father, y'all, family, y'all stick together. Pray for one another and love one another. Because you never know when your number is coming up. May God bless you. May God keep you. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.